Mary, who was taken from the left and the right field for a night attack of the Royal Air Force, and as you get to go in the little school, this is not the American stuff in the day, this is. The Royal Night Attack and the military camp were very close in the battle. We lost a lot of people who experienced the war, who took the thing that we wanted. The battle continued in China, the other side of all the engines, coming from the sea, going away to Germany, in this particular mission, there were 56 Lancaster bombers. The IAF lost 3% of the aircraft from the mission. So, 3% of the aircraft did not return to the base. This includes one Halifax bomber and one Lancaster. This is a picture of the famous Lancaster. Four engines were heavy bombers from the Royal Air Force. They were 10,000 aircraft for this, and they were typically in flying condition. One wing that is built in the lower part and one in the fire. So, the solar system is 7,000 aircraft. The crew, normally there were 7 crew members in the first half of the year. This time there was 8 person members. 8 person was the general Australian. And that's what happened to this Lancaster on the way back from the mission. They were attacked by a German nightfighter. It was a very experienced German nightfighter by the name of Staffel Capitaine Ernst Wilhelm Mulder. This is the German pilot. This is the crash site in the aircraft test. It's the only picture we have, and you see the impact on the right, and the German soldiers guarding the place. And you can see the dreadful incident is in the ground. And the meaning of that's why we're taking the building on the ground. This time there was a piece of the tail where we were 300 meters away from the crash. If you look at what's coming over here, this picture is taken by the fire after the crash. It's going to make the news that's going to pick them up. And this is the only thing, the only known room that we have is this power up. The little room is here, and it's the only thing, that's the thing we know from the aircraft, known to this air. This is a picture of the crew. In the picture we have, there are four of them in our name, which is known as the Meijde, who is a foundation to find the other families to fix. That's what our families do to continue to fix. This is their fleet. This is going to tell you a bit about them in a moment. This is the airman of their fleet, the family of Scotland. This is their brother and sister. And the
this is a lot of the experience for another 60. What do you know about this experience? Not a lot, right? The first thing that starts to use your mind. The oldest part of the user base is 23. The youngest position is 5 hours ahead of the other. The park is 21. One 3 minutes from 10. strong wind and the northern incident. It's predictable also after around 3% as opposed to the figures I mentioned before. There was only 30% chance of survival for 2 or 4 months. The head of Bath and Adam, after that, stopped there and personally crossed over. I want to look at the man who directed me into the library. It was only to say, I may not be.
And may I ask, Mr. Cruz, you, is that going to be the point?
A little bit of information here, I'm sure, will be with one, Joseph Green, so coming back in 1923. In Moscow, Saskatchewan, and now I'm in Fox Valley, which is some of the final, but also just seeing food. Even though he'd never seen it before, he's really been mystified. He filled out the attestation papers on January 28, 1942, to go in the rest of the world. In his interview report, indicates he's in good physical condition, a fine mod, and alert, quick, seamless mod, who have taken strict instructions therapy. He is home for 5 days at Christmas in December 24, 1942. Sunday, March 14, 1943, he wrote a letter to his sister that he was to leave his parents' station at Port of Superior and go to the Halifax Depot on April 4, 1943. He was an operator for the Lancaster bomb. He was on many missions bomb, deep into German the fateful mission was, as we saw before, May 27, 28, 1944, for an aggregate to bomb military camp in Bud Lutheran. And he lost there in the system. There were 24 war savings certificates of $5 each, which was returned to his father. And a life insurance policy from the National Life Company paid to his mother in the amount of $3,000, which is a small sum paid for the loss of a son and a brother. In his life home, you see a young man grow up in a really good house, and at one point he jokes about his hair one day, he was 21 years old. In his letters, he also states concern for his son's well-being, but we are also able to receive stress and fatigue take a toll on him. And leaving his letter to him, leaving family that never had a chance to meet Arvo, had the opportunity to learn and understand the man he was, and why he wanted to help with him. So, as Dave's siblings passed on, we extended family to her, probably for parents and grandparents, to keep their memory and theirs alive. I'd like to thank all people in the Netherlands and the local community here in the efforts to ensure sacrifices made by all the way down there, and women are not forgotten. So, my family, thank you.
It's my honor to accompany you today with my fellow colleagues to this people who are in the facility. Our goal is to maintain cultural relevance and original local communities, but we also find it very important to remember them who they are. As a father of 2 young children, I was very much feeling that children remain in joy. And it is something we have to work for. We will do our best to contribute to our children in the way that we do today. So I wish you a good evening.
We'll meet again, don't know where. Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. Again, don't know when, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again
Dames en heren, jongens en meisjes, ik zie er ook nog een aantal staan bij de ingang van de begraafplaats. Heel fijn dat er ook jongere mensen zijn. En het valt iedereen op, als je hier de begraafplaats binnenkomt, en u heeft dat vandaag ook wel gezien, valt iedereen op dat dit een bijzondere begraafplaats is. Omdat 8 militairen hier in 1944 zijn begraven. En dat ze niet ver van hier met hun vliegtuig zijn neergestort. En het monument, het kleine monument wat u hier ziet, dat getuigt daarvan. Het college van burgemeester en wethouders van Middelharnis, dat bezoekt ieder jaar op 4 mei de begraafplaatsen in onze gemeente, waar gesneuvelde militairen uit de Tweede Wereldoorlog zijn begraven. En zonder iemand iets te kort te willen doen, laat ik helder zijn, springt deze begraafplaats, dit monument en de graven, springt er wel uit. Want hier liggen 8 jonge mannen in de leeftijd van 19 tot 23 jaar. En die hadden menselijkerwijs gesproken nog onder ons kunnen zijn. Maar de geschiedenis besliste anders. Ze zijn om het leven gekomen in de strijd tegen de Duitse bezetter. En hebben hun leven gegeven zodat wij in vrede kunnen leven. En daar zijn we hen als inwoners van Goeree, Overflakkee en ook van Middelharnis nog steeds heel erg dankbaar voor. Die herinnering wordt zeker ook in leven gehouden door het goede werk van de stichting WO2GO. En ik wil nog een keer namens iedereen de grote waardering uitspreken voor hetgeen al gerealiseerd is aan panelen en herdenkingsmonumenten op ons eiland. Ik wens u allemaal een goede plechtigheid. Dank u.
Dreams by John Wright. I dreamt last night a dream of love eternal, a dream of peace, and all today my cares and hopes diurnal bring no release. For young men, will there ever dawn tomorrow so fair, so fine, when out the year's long tale of wrong and sorrow comes love like mine? Yet still the murmuring voice, this you have cherished, so this you know. Your dream was dreamed by dead young men who perished long years ago. If this be so, and no fulfillment seeming awaits for me, I pray that some young man may have my dreaming in years to be. Thank you.